Hi, I'm Severin. Nice to meet you.
You too.
I'm very happy to meet you. Really?
Me too.
It's good. Okay, so we put you the mic.
I gave you a microphone.
So don't worry. We have a lot of questions about the French fans.
Okay.
And cool, relax. Wake up very early.
I'm sorry.
You wake up very early.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
We saw you in the TV show.
Oh, you did?
Try to go. Yeah.
Cool.
It was good.
Thank you.
Okay, I can. So this mic is it's fake.
Here, I'll take this off. It's kind of hot.
Hi, Adam, the crazy guy of our team. He's very emotive today, I think.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Bonjour Brittany, je suis très contente d'être ici. Je suis ravie de te rencontrer. Je suis là en porte-parole. Nous sommes donc à New York, porte-parole de tous tes fans français qui ont de nombreuses questions à te poser. Nous avons pris tout ça dans nos valises. Et aujourd'hui, je vais te les poser. Est-ce que tu acceptes de dire toute la vérité et rien que la vérité?
Hi, hello, how are you?
So, we are today in the name of your French fans. We talk with us all the questions they want to know about you.
Okay.
Do you promise to say all the truth and only the truth?
Only the truth, of course.
Okay, it's good. On peut partir puisque c'est bon. Elle va dire toute la vérité. On est parti. Let's go. Tu as commencé ta carrière très jeune. Est-ce que de temps en temps, tu n'as pas l'impression d'avoir fait des sacrifices? You started your career very young. Do you have the feeling to have made sacrifices?
Well, when I was younger, there was times when I would have to leave and I wouldn't be able to go to my friend's birthday party or, you know, somewhat. But I don't have any regrets, though. I mean, I think sometimes you have to make sacrifices for things that you love to do or something that you want to do. And that's, you know, kind of one of them as, you know, an example, just being away from my family. But I think this is, you know, God's plan for me to do this. And so I'm happy doing what I'm doing.
Good. Est-ce qu'il y a des jours où tu n'as pas envie de tout lâcher et enfin de t'amuser et de profiter de la vie et faire ce que tu as envie? Yeah. Huh? Sometimes you feel like dropping out everything, just have fun.
Well, when I feel that way, I do. I have fun. I have like the weekends off, so well, every other weekend sometimes, and I have the dancers who travel with me, and you have to do normal things so you'll stay sane. Like example, go to the movies or go shopping or go to the spa. I always make time for fun things. So.
Yeah, and have a lot of presents. So, qu'est-ce que tu fais pour t'amuser? Okay, what do you do to have fun?
What do I do to have fun? Like what I just said, the dancers usually travel with me, so we'll go to the show, we'll go to the movies, go shopping. I love talking on the phone with my friends, and sometimes like the funnest thing for me to do is just to get in the tub, light candles, take a bubble bath, and talk on the phone with my mom, or read a book, just girl stuff like that.
Et sage, hein? Donc tu viens d'avoir 18 ans, et la question que tout le monde se pose, c'est: est-ce que tu vis encore chez tes parents? You just turned 18. The question everybody wonders is, do you still live with your parents?
Yes, I do. I still live with my parents. Every time I have time off, everyone asks me, do you have a place of your own? I was like, no, when I have time off, because I have a little sister. I mean, I have to go home and visit my little sister and my family and my brother and everything. So yes, I still live with my family.
Est-ce que ça veut dire que tu as encore besoin d'eux? It's because you still need them?
Yes, I do need them. I have to. I call my mom every night, so we just have that kind of bond. So,
est-ce que tu as gardé ta chambre d'adolescente? Do you, at your parents, did you keep your bedroom style just like when you were a kid? And what does it look like?
What does my room look like? Oh, it's still the same as when I was younger. I guess because now that I've gotten older, I've been traveling, so I haven't had time to change it to my personality now. But my room is really girly. I have dolls everywhere. I have a day bed. I have baby blue carpet. That's pretty much it. Yeah, and I have like the glow in the dark stars on my ceiling. So it's an interesting room, and I have pictures everywhere. So when you walk, most of the time when people walk into my room, they're just like, they're looking all around and stuff. So.
And when you were a kid, a little girl, do you admire a lot of stars? And which one?
Do I what? Did I
admire? Stars, artists, do you?
Oh yeah, when I was younger, of course. I remember when I first got my first Jambox, and I got Thriller, Michael Jackson's CD, and I put it in, and I would always play it, and my mom was like, turn it down, and Madonna, of course. So when I was younger, those were the two artists that I really idolized a lot.
And you meet them?
No, actually, no. I haven't met either of them. No, I would love to, though.
Not yet. Bon, je recommence. In French? It's your...
Oh. Okay, just... maybe
Est-ce que j'ai posé à quoi ressemble ta chambre d'adolescente?
Oui.
Ouais. Donc là...
Tout le monde, moteur demandé.
So you take a plane?
Yes, go home for a day.
Oh, the family.
Yes,
the best. I'm young too, 22.
You're 22?
I'm very young too.
I do.
Yeah, of course. Sometimes. Champagne.
Yes.
Bon, je pose mes questions, donc je fais attention. In French.
Et la deuxième question, c'est que tu les as, est-ce que tu les as rencontrés?
Ouais.
Excuse-moi. C'est bon, c'est à toi.
Je peux lui dire, tu as plein de poupées, ça veut dire que tu es encore un petit bébé?
Ouais.
Ok.
C'est quoi déjà la question là? Et quand tu étais petite, quelle star tu admirais? Ok.
Ok.
Tu les as rencontrés déjà? It's very special. So you have a lot of dolls.
Yes.
In your bedroom, and you're a little baby. Huh? You, comment on dit encore, still?
You stay a baby, you stay a child with all your dolls in your room.
In your heart.
Does it mean
when you were young?
When I was young, yeah.
You say you have many dolls right now in your room. Uh-huh. You stay having them?
Yes, so I still have
does
them.
Does it mean you stay a baby, a child?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay.
Bon, alors, maintenant je la pose en
bougez pas derrière parce qu'il y a, il y a une glace et donc on vous voit des fois en reflet en train de bouger. Merci, ça tourne.
Alors, tu me dis que tu as plein de poupées dans ta chambre, ça veut dire que tu es encore un petit bébé ou pas?
No, actually. I'm gonna continue to collect dolls. I'm 18 now, and I just got another doll for Christmas. So I don't think it's, you know, I'm considered a baby because I still collect dolls. But every Christmas, I told my mom, every Christmas, no matter how old I am, I want a doll, so.
And you have your doll. What do you think about it?
My doll?
Yeah, your doll.
Oh. Well,
Britney Spears' door.
Oh, my doll. I'm sorry. I'm out of it. Actually, I just saw the porcelain one because there's like a lot of different ones. I have the regular Barbie doll, and then for Christmas they gave me like the porcelain doll, and it's really pretty. It looks a lot like me, so it was kind of weird. I was like, oh my goodness, there's a doll of me. Kind of felt strange, but it's really pretty.
Donc tu as ta poupée Britney Spears. Qu'est-ce que t'en penses? Ok. Bon. Après. Quel est ton plus beau souvenir d'enfance? What is your best childhood memory?
My best childhood memory? It was probably Christmas one year at my grandmother's, and I remember I got a go-kart, and my friend did too. And it was just so wonderful because all of my family was there, and we had like a wonderful meal, and it was just, I don't know, it felt good in my heart, you know? And I don't know, we went there and it was just so much fun because my grandmother, she lives out in the country. So me and my friend, we got on our go-karts and we went out there and we went mud riding. And I was a tomboy when I was younger. So that was probably my favorite, my best childhood memory.
Donc, où ça? Là? Donc tes parents t'ont toujours soutenu dans ce que tu voulais faire. Si un jour tu as des enfants, est-ce que tu feras de même? Your parents always supported you in your career. If one day you have kids, would you do the same for them?
If they had that in them, if they wanted to, you know, sing or dance or whatever it is, if they really wanted to pursue that as their, you know, if they had that in their dreams and stuff and that's what they wanted to do, of course, I would totally support them. Yeah, definitely.
Est-ce que tu as envie d'avoir des enfants? Do you want to have kids one day?
Of course.
Kids,
yeah. Way down the line. That's something that I want to do. I want to, you know, take care of my career first because I have a lot I want to do out there. A lot I have to say, a lot that I want to do. But yes, when, you know, a couple of years from now, I would like to have 3 kids and the husband and the big home. And yes, of course.
And dogs.
Yes.
And the husband. Bon, après, ça je poserai après. Est-ce qu'il y a beaucoup de stars qui ont envie de te rencontrer? Are there a lot of stars that want to meet you?
Are there a lot of stars that want to meet me?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. That would be flattering. That would be really, really nice. I know there's a lot of celebrities I want to meet, but I hope so. That would be nice.
Wait. I think there is a lot. Vous me dites top. Et quelle star aimerais-tu rencontrer?
I would like to meet someone like Madonna. I've never met her before and I've idolized her since I was a baby. And someone like Brad Pitt because I think he is so cute and he's a wonderful actor. So someone like that.
And not Leonardo DiCaprio?
He's cute. I think he's a hottie, but I would like to meet Brad Pitt more though.
Donc je continue. Et Leonardo DiCaprio.
Huh?
Okay. Okay. Well, it's just in French. Okay. Ensuite, donc, et toi, c'est pareil en fait. Et toi, tu as déjà rencontré quelle star as-tu rencontré grâce à ta notoriété? C'est pareil.
Vraiment, parce qu'elle en a rencontré.
D'accord. Ok. Et toi, as-tu déjà rencontré des stars, justement, pendant... Attends. Est-ce que tu as déjà rencontré des stars grâce à ta notoriété? Très certainement. Ok. Who have you met now that you are famous?
Who have I met so far? Well, the MTV Europe Awards, I met Whitney Houston and Mariah Carey. And they were both really, really cool. And I saw Whitney perform. It was my first time ever to see her perform. And she was just amazing. Someone was trying to talk to me and I was like, no, let me just listen. I mean, I have her CD and it's amazing, but I think she actually sounds better live. I was really, really impressed. So those are the two people that I was really in awe over when I met. So I was really nervous. I was like, oh my God, what do I say? What do I do? It was funny.
Okay. D'abord, ton deuxième album. Donc, l'avenir pour toi ressemble à un conte de fées. D'abord, ton deuxième album. Et en quoi sera-t-il différent du premier? For you, the future looks like a fairy tale. First of all, your second album. And what is it going to be different from the first?
Well, 2 months ago, I was in Sweden and I recorded like the first 6 songs of the album. And after this trip, I'm going to go to Orlando and I'm going to finish up on it. But so far, the material's really, really cool. I haven't heard anything yet, like a finished song. But I don't know, the tracks are just really amazing and they're really funky. And it's a little bit more mature than the first album, I think, because I've grown as a person, so of course I'll grow as an artist. So I'm really, really excited about the next album. That's like my main focus right now. So.
And perhaps some surprise on this new album?
Maybe so. Maybe some surprise. I don't know.
Et peut-être des surprises sur ce nouvel album? Bon, je recommence. Et peut-être des surprises sur ce nouvel album? Ok, qu'est-ce que vous
voulez? Je voulais lui demander quelle sera la différence musicalement
Ok. Et au niveau du style musical, en quoi sera-t-il différent du premier en fait? Est-ce qu'il y aura des changements? Est-ce que tu... Enfin, Et musicalement, il y aura des différences sur cet album ou...
Well, basically, I mean, it's still pop music like the first album, of course, but when I was recording the first album, I just turned 16, so lyrically it fit me and everything, but now I think lyrically it's stronger, it has more attitude, the beats are funkier, but I don't know, I feel like I can express myself more, you know, with these songs. I can't wait to go on tour and actually perform them and everything. It's going to be really exciting because I've been performing the same thing for like a year now, so.
So, après, une série télé ou ciné en pré-projet, la comédie dans deux séries télé, oui, ok. Donc, là, tu vas peut-être, ça, et aussi, non, ouais, ça faisait bizarre la question, mais c'est pas grave. Tu dois jouer dans deux séries télé, est-ce que tu peux nous en dire plus sur tes rôles? Ok. Then there are going to be TV series in your plans. And can you talk about the story and the characters?
A TV series?
Yeah, no.
No, there is no TV series. Actually, I was thinking about doing one in February, but they scheduled me doing a tour in March and a tour in the springtime, so there's really no time for me to do television this year, but that is something I would like to experience down the road. But right now, I'm just really busy focusing on my music, so.
Yeah. Ouais, c'est ça.
I'm not doing that.
Ça, on est mal au courant, hein. La honte. Ok. Est-ce qu'un jour tu as envie de toucher au cinéma et jouer avec qui? Donc, do you one day want to be in a movie? And who with?
Yes, I would like to be in a movie one day. Who wouldn't? I just experienced that side of the entertainment business. I would like to try it out. But I know I would always come back to my music because that's my love and everything. But yeah, I would love to do a movie with someone like Ben Affleck or Brad Pitt. Someone like that would be nice, right?
Of course, I understand. La carrière et La carrière et le style de Christina Aguilera sont assez proches de toi. Qu'est-ce que tu penses de cette comparaison entre vous deux? Ok. Do you agree with the fact that the career and the style of Christina Aguilera are quite close to you? Do you know her, and why are you comparing to her?
Yes, I do know her. We used to work on the Mickey Mouse Club with each other. And anyone who is in this entertainment business, and I know at the point where she's at right now, she has worked really, really hard. I totally understand. So anything that's given to her, you know, she totally deserves. And I'm really, really happy for her. She's a sweet girl. So.
Yeah. Bon, je recommence la question parce que j'ai oublié un peu. Donc la carrière et le style de Christina Aguilera, oh putain de ta mère, sont assez proches de toi. Est-ce que tu la connais? Quelles sont les raisons de tes comparaisons? La carrière et le style de Christina Aguilera sont finalement assez proches de toi. Est-ce que tu la connais? Et comment tu expliques cette comparaison? Ok, c'est good?
Oui,
oui, oui. J'ai capito, j'ai capito. Est-ce que ça t'énerve qu'on la présente comme la nouvelle Britney Spears? Does it bother you that Christina has been told the new Britney Spears?
It doesn't bother me. I mean, I knew once the world accepted me as being, you know, I'm a young female pop artist, that there was going to be, you know, a lot more like the boy bands. But no, it doesn't bother me at all.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Elles ont commencé pratiquement ensemble, ouais. C'est une bonne amie à toi?
Well, we were really close when we were on the Mickey Mouse Club, and we talk when we get a chance to see each other. And we don't like talk on the phone and everything, but when we do see each other, we talk. You know, we're not like the best of friends, but we're friends.
Ok. Ensuite, bon, tiens, est-ce que tu es fan de shopping comme toutes les filles? Est-ce que tu achètes beaucoup de vêtements? You're a big fan of shopping, mm-hmm. Of course. Do you buy a lot of clothes?
Yes, I buy a lot of clothes. Now my fetish is shades. I have so many glasses, you don't understand. Like just like the pretend prescription glasses and just shades. But yes, I'm a shopaholic. I can't help myself.
Donc, bon, tes fans connaissent toutes tes qualités, mais est-ce que tu as des points faibles? Ok. Your fans know your qualities, but what are your weak points?
My weak points? I think I tend to worry a lot. I wish I wouldn't worry so much. And I analyze things way too much. That was one of my New Year's resolutions, is to stop analyzing things. And so far, not so good. What else? once I have my mind set on something, I really go for it. Well, I guess that's a good quality. But those are probably my two weak qualities, just, you know, analyzing things way too much and worrying. So.
Okay. Alors après, c'était quoi la question d'avant? Lana. Ouais. Est-ce que c'est toi qui choisis ton look? You choose your style.
Oh, I totally choose my style. I have a really cool stylist. She'll come in and she'll have like racks and racks of clothes for me to choose from. But most of the time, I'll come in and I can trust her because she knows my style and we go shopping with each other. But she'll bring the racks of clothes in and I'm always the one to pick it out. So, of course, you know best what looks best on you. So.
Ensuite, si tu croisais Britney Spears dans la rue, qu'est-ce que tu lui dirais et pourquoi? If you would meet Britney Spears on the street, what would you tell her and why?
If I was to meet me on the
street? Yeah.
If I was to meet me on the street, what I tell her, I would be like, I think you're cool. I wouldn't really bug her. Like, I'm the type of person, like, if I met a celebrity, I really wouldn't get on their nerves. I wouldn't want them to be at peace and do what they've got to do. But I would say something like, hi, what's up? Or I may, maybe not even say anything at all. Just go back home and be like, guess who I saw on the street, you know?
And you have your driving license. Tu as ton permis de conduire?
Oh, yeah, I have driving license, yeah. I have my license.
Bon, bien. La chance, not me. tes fans veulent aussi savoir l'importance qu'a l'argent dans ta vie. Your fans would like to know what is the importance of money for you in your life.
Money isn't that important to me. I mean, if now that I do have some money, I mean, I of course take care of my family and help them out and everything. But I think happiness is the most important thing. You can have all the money in the world, but if you're not happy, you have nothing at all. So.
That's true. It's a good way.
Faye, what are you thinking? Gotta mess up everything. The light.
Oh my gosh!
God!
I'm sorry.
Always in the way. The lame's in
the way. Sorry. Merci, Marc. Ok. Il faut y aller.
Si la dernière question, vous la voulez la prendre sur moi, moi j'avais. Ça pouvait être juste derrière son visage.
Toi, c'était bon pour toi avant?
Ouais.
Tu veux la renouveler la dernière fois?
Ok.
Juste la dernière.
De quoi?
On refait la dernière question.
D'accord. Ouais. C'était quoi l'importance
De l'argent.
One more time for the last question.
I'm sorry, I have the giggles.
No, don't worry. C'est normal que ça marche pas ton micro? Il est pas attaché? D'accord. Ok. Bon, on reprend. Tes fans voudraient savoir quelle importance a l'argent dans ta vie. About the money.
What?
About the money.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm going to start now. Well, now that I do have some money, I, you know, of course take care of my family financially and everything, but I don't think money is really, it's not really important to me at all. If you have happiness, that's what matters. So money is not that important.
That's true. Ensuite, quelle est la dernière folie que tu te sois payée? What's the latest crazy thing you offered to yourself?
I bought for myself?
Yeah.
Well, I just bought this ring the other day. Isn't it pretty?
Veux faire le gros plan? Vas-y, Adam.
Yeah, you wanna see? I don't know what got into me. I saw it and I was like, this is so beautiful and I don't have like, you know, a ring like this and I never really buy things for myself. So, well, besides clothes, but as far as jewelry goes, all this was given to me, like all my jewelry on me now was given to me. So I was like, oh, I want a beautiful ring. So this is the last thing I bought for myself.
It's your present.
Yes, it's my present to me.
Ok, c'est bon. Ensuite, quel est ton plus beau souvenir de scène? Ok. What's your best stage memory?
My best stage memory? Probably in Toronto. It was amazing because it was my biggest crowd I ever played. It was like my show. I mean, I've played for like in a stadium before for a radio show, but there was like, I think 20,000 people there. And it was like my first big show and it was just amazing. Like the crowd totally made me just crazy and I just like exploded on stage. So that was probably my best on stage memory.
In all the days. Ensuite, est-ce que tu as le trac avant de monter sur scène et comment le soignes-tu? Do you freak out before you go on stage? And how do you hear it?
Before award shows, I usually do, because it's my first time to do that performance, because I do a different performance for every award show. But generally, like when I'm on stage and I do my normal touring show, I don't really get that nervous because I'm used to doing it. Now, the first show I do, I'll be really, really nervous because I don't know how the crowd's going to react. But once you get in the routine of doing the same show every night, it's not like you're really nervous. It's just like you're excited, you know. But before award shows, oh, I get so nervous. I get really, really nervous. I can't. I block everyone out of my mind, and I'm like, people will be talking to me, and I'll be like thinking about something else. It's crazy. So yes, I do get nervous.
Bon, ensuite, qu'est-ce que tu fais de particulier juste avant de monter sur scène? Est-ce que tu as quelque chose que tu fais en particulier avant de monter sur scène, une espèce de rituel? What do you specifically? Yeah. Just before you go on stage, something like a ritual.
Before I go on stage, usually we'll say a prayer, me and the dancers and the band, and you know, we'll try to get the crew together if they're around, and just to make us feel better about things before we go on stage. And I do sit-ups and I do like push-ups just to pump myself up. Unless I'm really tired, I don't do that. So those are the things. Usually just the prayer.
Ensuite, est-ce que tu les vois souvent? Et tes meilleurs amis, est-ce que tu les vois souvent? Et est-ce qu'ils ont changé d'attitude maintenant que tu es connu? And what about your best friends? Do you often see them and did they change their attitude towards you?
No, not at all. I mean, I don't keep in touch that good with my friends at school because they're busy doing their thing. I mean, we'll get phone calls to each other every now and then. But my friends that I grew up with that live around me, of course, like, we're always together. Every time I go home, we're with each other. And they haven't changed at all, and I haven't changed at all, so it's good.
They don't care.
No, they don't care. They're like my sisters, you know, so.
Okay, et ensuite, ça y est. As-tu célébré l'an 2000 avec tous tes amis et qu'est-ce que tu as fait?
Did you celebrate year 2000 with your friends? And what did you do?
Yes, I celebrated it with my friends. We went to this penthouse, and it was beautiful because we saw fireworks, and I was with the people I love, and I was with my friends, and we had a blast. It was so much fun.
Ensuite, c'est bon, là on a fait toutes les questions de cette page. Oui, oui, mais justement, c'est pour la fin.
Il nous reste 5 minutes.
Ouais. Ouais, c'est en dernier, ça. Do you have a message for your French fans? Est-ce que tu as un message pour tes fans français qui nous regardent?
Do you want me to do it to the camera? Or...
Yeah, if you want.
Which one do you want me to do it to?
Laquelle elle regarde? The big one.
Big one.
Okay.
The big one.
I want to tell all my French fans, thank you so much for all your love and support. It means so much to me. And this spring, I'm going to be doing a world tour, so I can't wait to see you guys really soon.
And soon on stage, perhaps?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Bientôt sur scène, peut-être?
Yeah, I'm excited.
Okay. So, questions, the last questions. Bon, j'ai rien oublié sur les autres, hein? On est bien d'accord. Okay. Alors, il y a beaucoup de garçons, t'imagines bien, qui sont amoureux de toi et qui se demandent si tu as un petit ami en ce moment. There are lots of boys in love with you that wonder if you have a boyfriend at the moment.
No, I do not have a boyfriend at the moment. I'm single, so.
Okay.
Do I meet people? So what's the question?
Do you understand why all the boys fall in love about you?
Oh, why? Oh, okay, c'est ça? I see.
Alors, c'est quoi la question exacte? Ah oui, d'accord. Et avec tous ces garçons autour de toi qui sont fous, qui sont complètement fous de toi, t'en as pas rencontré un?
Well, I've met a lot of really cute guys, but I guess I just haven't found that special person yet. So, I have plenty of time.
Bon. Et à quoi ressemble ton histoire d'amour idéal? For you, what's the ideal love story?
The ideal love story? To meet someone when you, like, that you really love when you least expect it, you know, and they just sweep you off your feet and they totally cherish you and are just totally infatuated with you and totally in love with you. And take you out to dinner all the time and call you, just really romantic and make me laugh. And they love me for me and not just for who I am.
Et donc, oui, on va poser la dernière question. Hein? Stéphane, aimerait que tu parles de cette rumeur qui court en ce moment entre toi et le prince William. Your fans, would you like you to talk about this rumor between you and the prince William?
Well, I really don't like to talk about my, that part of my private life, but I think he's really cute.
So that story about a letter he would have written to you is false.
Huh?
Comment on dit false? False.
False.
This they talk about a letter he write for you, written for you. It's false.
Well, we write it. Well, I don't know. We don't want to talk about this.
Donc je pose la question. Donc, cette histoire de lettres de fans qu'il t'aurait envoyé, elle est fausse, en fait.
OK.
Bon, après, j'ai fini par la dernière question. It's the last one. Alors maintenant, je voudrais savoir si tu as dit toute la vérité et rien que la vérité. Did you say all the truth and only the truth?
I said all the truth and only the truth. Yes, I did.
Thank you, Brittany.
Oh, thank
Congratulations
you.
For this new year. Wish you a lot of things, energy and success, and stay like this.
Thank you so much. It was nice meeting you.
Alors, au nom de toute l'équipe de Fan 2, nous, on te souhaite une bonne année, pleine de bonnes choses, d'énergie, de rester telle que tu es, parce que tu es parfaite. Nous, on t'aime en France, et puis bravo pour tout ce que tu fais. À bientôt. See you soon.
Okay, you too.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
C'est good?
On ne coupe pas, on ne coupe pas, je vais faire un clap de fin pour la 5.
Some questions with the fan.
Okay.
Attends, tu coupes pas.
About 10 minutes.
Attends, okay. We'll ouais, tu couperas pas.
Hi.
Tu me regardes?
Oui.
Tibrine,
tu me passes un tour. Tu me regardes, Adam?
Ouais.
Adam, fais mes mains. Vous me voyez mes mains?
I must okay, ask you something for my brother.
Oh yes.
He's eating just right on the raft and just take a picture of
the phone.
Okay?
Thank you.
Cute pants.
Learn. It's lady song. It's French.
Cute, very cute.
Just
okay. Voilà. Tu gardes ta veste ou pas?
Oui.
Yeah, sure. Parce que... Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was really cool.
Yes, c'est bon? Merci. Thank you.